that he also attempted to rewrite the Silmarillion in the style of the Hobbit. I have those papers for you now. In a hole in the fabric of reality, there lived a god. Not a nasty, angry, vengeful god, with jealousy and a punch up for smiting, but a distant, uninterested god with nothing comfortable to say. This was Eris, and that means the one. Eru Ilúvatar was sitting in his void one day, smoking an enormous long pipe, and suddenly, out of his imagination, popped a little man. Manway, at your service. This is unexpected. Hello, Ilúvatar, at yours, the god said, too surprised to say anything else. From the silence that followed became uncomfortable, he added, I'm just about to sing a song, pray come join in. In fact, they had hardly reached the third verse, when there came another little man out of Eru's imagination. Melkor, at your service. I see the others have already begun to arrive. Oh, thank you, Eru said with a gasp. It was not the correct thing to say, but we had begun to arrive. It really flustered him. Come along and join the choir, he managed to say after taking a deep breath. A solo effort would suit me better if it's all the same. I don't mind some caroling, some Christmas caroling, if you have it. Lots, Eru found himself saying, although what the devil Christmas was, he had no idea. Soon enough, Manway and Melkor were talking like old friends. As a matter of fact, they were brothers. Eru had just struck up another chord when suddenly, a pair of little people came tumbling out of his imagination. What can I do for you, my dears? He said. Varda, at your service, said one. And Javana, said the other, and they both bowed. Yours and your family's, replied Eru, remembering his manners. Manway and Melkor are here already, I see, said Varda. Let us join the throng. Throng, thought Mr. Ulubata. I don't like the sound of that. But before he could sing another note of the song, there came a scrambling and scurrying of little people inside his head. He was very cross at this point. He let them all come pouring out in a sudden flurry. Hundreds, even thousands of them all came out, singing and dancing and clattering and chattering. Now we are comers to sing. Come, fustigate and be bothered, these Ainur. And then they sing together in harmony. And then the Ainur began to sing all together in one voice, and then Professor Tolkien has just scribbled out the next few rhymes and written, no, no, no.